Hello, how are you, Spencer? Aaron?
6 o'clock.
Of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Clerk Kayden Aldrich, will you call the roll, please?
Philip Kern, present. Sandy Flora.
Here.
Mike Isley.
Here.
Spencer Henry.
Here.
Jody Nelson.
Here.
We move next to the reading of the minutes from July 14. Special meeting presented here for approval under any additions, subtractions, additions, amendments to the set of meetings. Is there a motion to approve?
Motion to approve the minutes. Second.
Without objection, motion carries. We will suspend the common council meeting at 6:01 PM. And open the public hearing on the additional appropriation request for $200,000 from the general fund for use in the construction of the next level trails project for the Monmouth Honor Bridge. Is there anyone who wishes to be heard on this topic? There being no one present to speak on that topic, public hearing was closed at 6:01 PM. We resume the council meeting. Next up are the committee reports. The fire territory held a joint meeting with the township advisory board on June 23rd to review the 2022 budget as presented by Dan Dugan. The individual township boards approved the budget. The executive board met immediately following and also voted to approve the 2022 budget. The executive board also met on July 28th and approved the transfer of the smoke truck to Erica Draper, who is forming a not-for-profit organization, a domestic animal rescue team. The trailer will be outfitted with cages and other equipment to allow the transport of multiple animals during events such as floods, fires, or abusive situations. The Carroll County Transportation Committee held their first meeting on long-range transportation plan for the county. And among the items that the city has asked the committee to address is a truck route for the downtown to divert traffic away from pedestrian areas, especially the courthouse section, Washington Street, and just partly go back to the State Road 25 route that was in place of the 421 route to Ryan Street for truck traffic that's traveling through to the Peters Drive. The Perseus Board of Governments met on July 29th and reviewed claims, grants that occurred and being administered by the agency along with Head Start programming and other agency initiatives. Sandy, do you want to update us on area plan?
Yeah, we have area plan meeting on the 27th. We have a proposed budget that didn't pass. We approved a new subdivision on New Acres, just off of the Bridger Apartment. Come see it when you go up to Lafayette. We are now broadband ready. Okay. There was some discussion about the subdivision ordinance. It was last updated in 1992. And would maybe an update is in order, maybe adding a checklist for new developers. We have, let's see, we've got 25 new residences year-to-date. Cameron did three assignments for new 911 addresses, 28 site visits, compliance certifications. He had 11. So our total value that we put debt this year to date is $24,553,613, with fees of $39,626.
Thank you, Sammy. Gail, would you update us on the debt resolution information?
We've had a few meetings. The last one was an informative session with Matt Eckerly from Baker Tilly, and also Ken Remenschneider from Lehorn. And we saw a PowerPoint presentation about the TIF revenue. He answered questions from the public and the commissioners, and then Kim showed the Burnbrae Farm concept plan. He had a PowerPoint presentation for that as well. So it was really more of an informative session, but we are meeting again in a few weeks to continue discussions about the process of creating a residential TIF. And I know you and Joe had a meeting with some of the school board representatives and the superintendents as well. So it's still kind of just in the thought process at this point and presenting information.
Yeah, so we had a meeting last month. It's pretty straightforward. Mostly it was just a preview budget, which was passed, and just some voting about mailers for other county recycling events. Nothing really that became the Carroll County Airdrop Black Friday.
Any other reports? The council is represented with written department head reports, so without objection, department head reports are incorporated by reference into the minutes. And before we proceed with the rest of the agenda, Diane Coghill and Mary Cox have asked to speak with the council regarding their concern about matching funds that they had spent a couple of years ago for the sidewalk in front of their home. And they now the two projects have been completed. Standing Elroy and now Walt Wilson Street, where sidewalks are being provided without match, and of course the council approved the program with the last budget of 100%. So, please, you have the floor.
I'm Diane Coghill from North Street.
Operator Cox.
Like Mayor Worling said, we are here regarding the 50-50 curb and sidewalk program. I believe we were in the last group of participants for that program. It was 2019 when we received the letter that our curb and sidewalk was in need of repair. And it was our understanding at that time that if we wanted to have them repaired, the 50-50 program was the only option, or they just wouldn't get done. And we knew that program had been in place for many years. So now we understand the program has changed to where homeowners are paying zero cost. And Wilson Street, 10 homes are getting free curbs and sidewalks. No cost to those residents. And to me, when I drive down there and I see those being done for nothing, and think just a short time ago we were out $2,000. A little over $2,000 actually. So I started looking through past council notes about it, and I saw it was mentioned on at least three occasions that 50-50 participants would be upset if others got for free what they were required to pay. But then there didn't seem to be any further discussion about it or any resolution about it. So I guess our feeling is that we took the initiative to improve our property, help our neighborhood, and because others chose not to do so for whatever reason, they are getting it done for free. And we feel like that we should receive some sort of compensation, that all residents should be treated fairly and equally. And so we ask that the council give us some thought, maybe what could be done to help those that did, spend fixing up the north end with curbs and sidewalks is a good thing. You know, we're not opposed to that at all, but we don't want to turn a good thing into a negative for others. And that's how we feel, you know, that it should be a positive thing for the town and not cause hard feelings.
I appreciate your comment. Did you have other, I think what we will do is take that under advisement if that is agreeable with you. And Randy, did you have something?
No.
Anything else?
We put it together, but she talked about it. I said all mine in here too.
Are you guys on East North Street or West? East North Street?
Corner of North and West Street.
Okay.
We appreciate the opportunity.
We will.
Is that our viewpoint?
Absolutely. We appreciate your comment and we'll take that under advisement and we will be back in touch.
Okay.
And if you wish to stay for the rest of the meeting, you're more than welcome. But if you don't, that's understandable.
No offense to anybody, but I don't think I will. You've seen how many times I come to these meetings. But thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The next item of our business is unfinished business. I left a voice message for Ashley Wilson this afternoon. We've been talking about information over the last few weeks concerning the community center's request for relief on cleaning supplies and facility cleaning for the events that are scheduled at the Apple Center. These would be obviously events that were charged. We're discussing some long-term remedies that will take a while to figure out and be more involved than the issue at hand. So the short-term remedy that we have discussed and which the Board of Works approved earlier this evening is that for the rentals, and I think we established the date from July 1st to the end of the year, and they're on until we come to a different type of arrangement. For each rental, which is typically $150 for the first 4 hours, and then there is a charge for subsequent hours. $50 of that fee would be committed by the city to the community center to cover costs of cleaning and cleaning supplies. And because the amount that they had asked for initially was $25, this would help them to kind of catch up on the supplies from earlier in the year. I wanted to present that to the council as well and ask if you would like to also do a motion to adopt that.
What motion?
Second. We have a motion and a second. Any discussion?
I have a couple of questions. The rental fee, where is that put or kept or accounted for?
In the community center fund.
Okay. And then if they need like something for maintenance for the building,
they have to come out of the fund.
Gutter cleaning, sidewalk, all of that kind of it comes out of that rental money.
Right.
And then who performs those tasks? Do they have to hire somebody or does the city?
The city owns the building and so the city would contract with them.
Okay.
So anything that, you know, if it's air conditioning or heat plant, whatever, at this point in time, that would be a city expense that would be gained for all of that community fund.
And then were they agreeable to, I think Linda Marner was cleaning. Is she agreeable to continue that or do we have to find somebody to clean?
That will be up to them.
Okay.
If we are reimbursing them for cleaning, then if they need to find someone else to do that, that would be
what we're
providing funding for cleaning and supplies. So that will be their decision.
Okay.
Any further questions? All those in favor of the motion, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
First first item of new business is resolution 2021-7, for additional appropriation of $200,000 from the general fund to the next level careless project for construction. Is there a motion to pass resolution 2021-7?
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor, say aye.
I was waiting for him to go first. Did you get, because he made the motion, so I was going to ask him if he was going to speak. I have a few questions. I know that the change order that we saw a month or so ago was for about $650,000. Things that were taken out of the original.
Removed from the original project.
So those things were in the original project scope. Are they not necessary, or are they going to come back to us at some point in time for an appropriation?
Well, they may be done under other, using other funds at different times. So it could be on a street project, for example, to do the entryway into North Park. There's not a set timetable for those other pieces to occur.
So the original grant for that was what dollar amount?
It was 183,000 or 163,000. Do you remember off the top of your head, Dan?
Was that from the
I thought it was 163,000.
Yeah, that was the initial amount that was provided a couple of years back. And then we just received a thing around 168,000.
Right.
1,680,000.
Okay.
Get
and I know you had said to me at one point in time that was something that was started or originated in 2019.
Sure.
Okay, so that amount of money was supposed to cover the scope of this, but the value of the land being used as the city's match, and we were not supposed to have to put anything into this. And I know since this has opened back up, T-Bird has submitted a change order for $30,000 additional, which was approved. Tonight you approved 54.1 additional dollars. And we're being asked to appropriate another $200,000. So we're knocking on $300,000 of city money when we weren't supposed to have to contribute a dime to this. So what happened between 2019 and today that now it's costing us money?
And certainly on the construction side, obviously the bids came in about 30% over what had been initially projected. So instead of it being around $1 million, the bid came in at over $1.5 million. Similarly, in the NLM marks, found their bid that was expected to come in at around $100,000, come in at $130,000. So they are scrambling to try to cover that as well. Construction costs, as I think everyone can attest, have skyrocketed. And so we're faced with a situation where we either proceed with the project and put in the additional $200,000, the others have already been approved, and or we return close to that amount to DNR for the work that has already been done under the grant funds that were extended to us, I think about $183,000. Close to mine, does that sound about right?
It was my understanding we have to go backwards and everything we had spent on that grant would have to be paid back if we did not.
Right, and I think that amount is just under $200,000. So we either pay back $200,000 or we put $200,000 in and continue and have something that is
so that
worthwhile to the community.
That $200,000 you're talking about, that didn't come out of the grant monies?
That came out of an earlier grant, which was contingent on us completing this entire project. So if we do not complete this project, we would be subject to returning that to the DNR.
So in 2019, were there bids done at that time?
For the first phase of the project.
Okay, so we're looking at a second phase, is that?
The first phase was primarily engineering, and so, you know, doing the survey, doing the geotech survey to determine what the condition, how to remedy the slope,
right,
the issue with the slip. So that, you know, precursor to construction was the first phase of the project.
So the bids that were, they're working from now, when were those bids received and has it been a while?
No, it's been, those were open a few months.
Just recently?
Yeah.
So you're not sure if at some point in time that the rest of that change order cost is going to come back to us for an additional appropriation?
I can't say that it won't, but I can probably guarantee you that it won't be this year. As we are, you know, working on other construction projects with the city. So it's not likely that we'll be seeking an additional appropriation for the Walnut Pike Bridge.
Other than the 54-1 that the board worked, so we have to have an additional appropriation for that yet?
Unless we take that out of other accounts. I think we were looking at MVH for that.
Okay.
If there is sufficient funds left in MVH, we should know that within a couple of weeks.
And what's the term, or the finish date for this project? Is it that this year?
Yes, it'll be, I think milestone's completion date is October 13th.
But now, just to clarify on me, we either put in the 200,000 or we have to pay back the ENR 183 if we made nothing after the 183. The 200,000 gets us, it helps get this to London High.
Correct. And yeah. You should realize too that we are in construction, so it's now no longer a simple matter of saying, okay, but we'll give them back to you. But as they say, now, at this point, with the delays that occurred, having to do the public hearing, we are now a little past the start of construction. So, it would be kind of a different ball of wax, and hopefully council could advise us what we would need to do then. But this is the board is kind of out of the water now.
Let's simplify it. 200,000 gets us a project, otherwise we just do it really fast. 200,000.
And we have a huge other problem because we had to start construction. And we have the remaining portion of the $10 in our accounts. Any further discussion?
So with what Diane Cockrell said earlier with the sidewalks, budget all this money last year for purpose of this year or last year for sidewalks? Was that true? That's right. Could be a lot. That's right. So it's like maybe for 2022, we're looking at maybe a little less sidewalks, having incurred this cost, and maybe we can revisit that because that was about $100,000 for sidewalks at least.
That's that we had almost $300,000 for sidewalks.
So I think there's we've not really spent any of that money. So it's like
the only thing that we've spent is some engineering dollars for what we're going to cycle to do the inventory of the sidewalks.
Which is good to have.
Yes,
so
which we now have, which is now in the GIS system. So we'll use that to identify the areas where the sidewalks and streets are the worst, so we can combine those into a street project, or to determine which sections of sidewalk, maybe five or three to five, need to be considered for replacement.
Having to do this now, do we can play somewhere else where we reduce down so the sidewalk can actually reach. We still have any money appropriated this year, so
that's correct.
We can
definitely stay there as an appropriation.
Sure.
An encumbrance that is out of, I think, 110 out of debit, 110 out of rainy day, and 80 out of brick and mortar. So the only thing that has been extended is so, any further discussion? Any question? All those in favor of Resolution 2021-7 for additional appropriation of $200,000 from the general fund to the next level trails project, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Any extensions? 2 hour from all there.
Are you considering it from the fire department?
So it's from?
The alley behind the fire department to Main Street.
Correct.
What kind of stirred this, the company?
It was really from the fire department. That also, you know, desire to have a sign that they can hang the snow removal street sweeping on as well. Because this area, this whole area is identified as an emergency route. The snow removal and, there's very much for us. But primarily it was for, being able to free up some of that parking and then do, just people parking there all day or sometimes 24 hours. And some of those tend to be used by panel companies, residents. And so it, creates an issue.
Because it's on the side of the street.
It's already 2 hours on the other side.
I mean, at some point, that's going to change it or traffic flow is going to change.
Traffic flow will change, but it doesn't mean that the parking, designation will change. So, is there a motion for this proposed ordinance 2021, actually?
I motion 2020-04.
Sandy, do you have a second? I didn't hear. I thought someone said something. If someone else said something first, that would be fine. Just let me know. So that is a second. Any discussion, further discussion on proposed ordinance 2021-04?
You said the other side, the west side, is already to.
Pretty sure that is, I can pull that up if you'd like.
I was just curious as to the rest of that block.
I think the rest of the block is, would still be all bed.
All bed.
I mean, the rest of the, from the alley.
To Franklin Street.
On the east side. I think that is still all bed. So if there was a desire to amend this to include that and make that 2 hour, that would be a possibility. There are businesses out.
So 347 would be 2 hour, 140 West Street would be all bed.
Oh, you said. Would you like to add to the ordinance?
Sure.
It just makes us confusing, I think, to people. It was all the same.
And so your amendment would be to.
The whole thing to our plan.
To change it from Main to the alley to Main, from Main to Franklin, is that correct? On the east side of the street.
You want the west side too, or just the east side?
I'm pretty sure it's already two.
Okay.
The attorney office has been there again.
That is 2 hour there in the hand.
Pretty sure it's 2 hour, around border park on the restaurants.
Yeah.
You're willing, has there been any discussions, I was thinking about this, my reporter. Those remaining parking spaces are in the line, they're not at the angle, like on the other side of the street. When we change that, will that parking change as well, since there's only going one way? We need it.
We talked about that.
The change of the angle parking, and actually you probably gained a couple parking spots that way.
Yeah.
So I think that would be whatever here in the street parking.
We have to figure out whether, if there's a wide enough area, presumably that would be all right, but we have, look at it.
I wouldn't second his amendment.
Okay, so. those in favor of the amendment to extend the two-hour parking from on the east side of South Union Street from Main to Franklin, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion on the amendment carries. And now on the proposed ordinance on first reading, 2021-11. All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye. I move that we suspend the rules and pass this on three readings tonight.
That requires a unanimous vote to suspend the rules and accept to pass on second and third readings and same night as introduction. All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries. Who seconded that, please? You got that in with no one hearing you. That was pretty good. So to pass the proposed ordinance 2021-11 on the second reading, we have a motion.
Motion, Joe. Second.
Discussion. That was the passing amendment.
Yeah.
All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
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 Carries your amendments. And then to pass proposed ordinance 2021-11 on the public of the number nine readings. Session on the budget. We have documentation. What we do in general tonight, that we need to kind of talk about broad brush, what the strategies are. The city is heading with projects and so forth that are up and coming, and which are kind of guiding the budget recommendations. And obviously, we'll have a chance to study this before we get into the actual work session. We have proposed that we will meet next Monday, August the 9th at 6 o'clock for a second round on the work session. Is that time still available? Yeah. All good. Notice out to get you on that.
Thank you.
So, I believe I sent out a sheet that kind of outlines the strategies and budget priorities. We are seeing an opportunity of many generations for the possibility of fairly significant residential development and the business development that we go along with that. With that, we'd like to recommend and establish multi-zone comprehensive land use planning and transportation, get those plans updated. So I'm recommending that we establish a community development and planning department and get into that and continue the code enforcement that is seeing, I think, significant progress. Chugging away at trying to get some properties that haven't been improved, but there are number of success stories out there. Mark Carmen is on vacation for the next 2 weeks, but we'll invite him to come to our September council meeting to kind of update you on where we are with that. Obviously, we want to continue the road and sidewalk improvements with community match, community crossings, matching grant, and sidewalk projects. Do now and assess those projects of highest priority using the GIS system that the Fairbanks Archer has populated with the most recent street assessment and also with the sidewalk assessment. That that database is accessible to you. What I would recommend is that perhaps that at the end of one of our council meetings, or perhaps during the next work session, take you through what that looks like, and then you know, get your passwords and be able to go in and access the information on a regular basis. So we will budget $333,000 for matching funds for community crossings. We made a 25% match at our population level, so that would assume a full project of $1 million. And then also budget for the engineering for making sure that we can prepare the construction estimates, good documents, and handle inspections on those projects. We're in the process of doing wastewater analysis, and that will probably net results by the end of the year and give us a roadmap for what we're going to do to expand the wastewater treatment plant. Currently, we're looking at probably doubling capacity over the next 5 years, and so what will that project look like?
Is that going to be in lieu of the second plant south of town, or in addition to?
We don't know yet. We're still determining where we are with reviewing basically whether we can. The one south of town would require a second discharge permit. So that's the first thing that we're checking on the item. The next would be, can we, without a second discharge permit, we could not build a full plant there. So that would be, would make sense to have a larger pre-treatment plant there and send that flow to the existing plant, or do a full expansion of the current plant. So those are the alternatives that they are assessing now.
Any discussions with IPA yet for contributions to any of this?
Much too early. They contribute a third to the study. So and the Carroll County RDC is contributing a third to the study. So those discussions will of course take place when we have projects to when we have engineering costs. We're also involved in a ready project, which is regional economic acceleration, blah blah.
Initiative.
The initiative, yes, at the end. And Carroll County is in with Greater Lafayette Commerce on this project. And as of probably a couple of weeks ago, there's $50 million available from the state, basically, that will be distributed to 10 communities and a chunk of $500 million from the state, with $50 million being awarded to each of 10 communities. There are 15 separate ready projects throughout the state, so 10 of those will be successful. I think we have six or seven counties that are coordinating on this. White, Devon, obviously Carroll, Tippecanoe. Do you know the other two?
Okay, Thompson.
process right now is that the individual counties are submitting projects that they would like to have funded back to Greater Lafayette Commerce, and then the Board of Governments will rank and select the top projects that they want to submit as part of the application, which is due towards the end of August. And I think we've submitted, or will submit by the end of this week, the deadline is extended by the four or five projects in Carroll County. And for us, those include residential infrastructure, regional residential housing initiative, a couple of trail projects, and two actual residential projects. The one that is being discussed for the area by Canal Commons, I'm sorry, by the canal, 20-acre parcel there, and then the River Commons is being submitted as a project for infrastructure funding. So if any of those projects that are mostly in the city were to be selected, there would be a one-to-one match from the public projects for those expenses. So we would need to consider where that match would come from. Obviously, the city has healthy reserves. We have ARPA money that we will need to determine how to spend as well. Infrastructure is one of the areas in which that can be spent. And of course, we're also involved in Regional Opportunity Zone Initiative. We have no costs associated with that. That will bring us additional marketing tools in the next few months to try to entice investors to the Delphi area. In terms of budget priorities, the city building, we know it's going to need renovations and repairs. We've asked that the investigative unit on space elsewhere, because our police department is literally they're holes in the floor, and we cannot move them anywhere to complete renovations for that space until the investigation begins. That is relocated from there upstairs. So renovating, adding a restroom, at least one restroom to the second floor, and temporarily relocating the police department, and then fixing and renovating a squad room is the top priority. Creating an office area for the clerk treasurer within the clerk's department, and then further renovation of the second floor once the police are able to relocate back down to their space. We're hoping to be able to move the water department into a building out towards well 5. We'll know more on the feasibility of that when we see how much funding is left. There'll be savings from the water project. It won't be enough to complete the building, but it would certainly put up a shell, and we can make them to complete that building, but that would be out of water funds for the water. So we'll now to close this for Carroll County.
So the renovations, will they include like electrical upgrades or anything like that? Is that part of it?
That's a very good question. Certainly as they get into redoing a whole space like the current police department, they can look at upgrading the electrical. Obviously the building is 1928 vintage, and while some of the areas have had work done to them and modernization, most of it is still the wire and redo areas that may